Students, welcome back in a biology session and very warm good morning to all of you. So today I have bring you the new lesson and very interesting lesson also, and the name of the lesson is what? Cell. Okay, so what is mean by cell, what it contain, what are their functions, or which are the different cell organelles are present, and we are going to discuss all deeply in this cell lesson. Okay, so as we know, on the earth there are the lot of number of the plants and animals are present, but on the earth, along with the living things, there are the certain non-living things are also living. Okay, so if we talk about the living things, then the plants and animals and the human being, all these are what? Living things. And there are some called as biotic components. While on the other hand, there are the certain non-living things which we are calling as what? Abiotic components. For example, we can see this soil is there, air is there, water is there. All these are what? Abiotic components. Okay. So which things makes the living thing different from the non-living thing? So as you know, there are the certain characteristics which are performed by the living things. For example, we can say that digestion, respiration, excretion, circulation, all reproduction, all these are the certain processes which are performed by the living things. Okay, and which makes the living thing different from the non-living things. But certain non-living things also can move like a living things. But that is not true proper sentence. Okay, the living things can move when the human beings or when the non-living things can move, when the living things drive them or make them changes into them. For example, we can say that the cars can move, but cars alone will not move from one place to another place. If we drive the car, then only it will change its place. Okay, so these are the certain things which makes the living thing and non-living different from each other. So on the earth, there are so many living things are present, there are so many animals and so many plants are present on the earth, and there is so much variety and so much diversity is there in the living thing. But one common thing is there in the living thing is that what? The all the living things are made up of cell. Okay, so all the living things are made up of cell. So let's discuss what is meant by the cell. Okay, so the cell is the structure and the functional unit of a living organism. For now, we keep in the mind is that all the living things are made up of cell. We are going to see the definition of the cell deeply in the next upcoming session. Okay, so first we will go through the first point, that is what? Discovery and history of the cell. Okay, so the English scientist, the name of what? The English scientist Robert Hooke discovered the cell in 1665. Okay, so there was a great English scientist and the name was what? Robert Hooke. So that Robert Hooke discovered the cell in the year 1665. So what he has done that time, he has taken the one cork of the plant. Now cork means nothing but what? The bark of a plant. Very thin portion of the bark of the plant he has taken, and he observed that under his microscope. That was not that time, that there was not an invented microscope like that we are using now, the compound microscope and the electron microscope. Okay, so see here in the image I have shown you how it said in the books microscope. Okay, so under this microscope Robert Hooke observed that cork. Okay, and what he found out that time, he found out that there are the room like structures are there. Okay, so there are the separate compartments are there. Or it almost looks like a hives or the honeycombs are there, it looks like that. But all the living material in that cells are get destroyed from that. Okay, so that time the Robert Hooke find is each part, each compartment is separate from each other, and it looks like a hollow room, empty room. So he coined this each compartment as a cell. Okay, as a cell. So it means what? We can say the empty room or the empty cabinet is called as what? Cell. So we can say that what? He coined the term cell. Who coined the term cell? Robert Hooke. Okay. So after the invention of the Robert Hooke, after his discovery, from that 150 years, there was not that much there was not that much discovery regarding to the cell. Okay. So this is all about what? Discovery and history of the cell. Now we'll discuss that which type of the instruments we have to use to do the study of the cell. That is what? Instruments for studying the cell. So as we know, the cells are the very smallest particle of our body. It is a very minute thing. So to observe it, we have to use the microscope. So it is called as a microscopic part of the body also. Okay. So to observe the cell, we are using the compound microscope. Okay. To observe the cell, generally we are using the compound microscope. See in the image. Like this compound microscope, generally we are using in the science laboratory to do the certain work. And it works on the lens and the visible light. But if you want a high resolution, if you want to observe each and every organelle from the cell, then we have to use another microscope, that is called electron microscope. And this electron microscope works, or it uses the electromagnetic works on that. Okay. So these are the certain instruments that we have to use for the study cell. Next point is that is staining. Okay, so these cells are the colorless part, or the colorless substance present in the human body or in the living things. Okay, so if you want to observe this cell, then we have to give certain colors to the cell. Okay, so in order to give the certain colors to the cell, we are using certain chemicals, and that chemicals are called as what? Or that process we are giving the color to the cell, they are called as what? Staining. Okay. So like a certain stains we are using. Stains is not the chemical which we are using to give the color to the cell. So the stains like safranin, eosin, methylene blue and crystal violet, all these are the stains that we are using to do the staining process for the cell. Okay. Now we move for the very important one, that is unicellular and multicellular. So these are obviously not the different word or the new word for you. Already you have discussed this word, but still let's see deeply about this unicellular and the multicellular. So as we know, there are the certain organisms on the earth which are made up of only one cell. Okay, obviously then it will be very minute, very tiny. So to observe them, we have to use the microscope. That is the reason they are called as what? Microscopic organisms also, okay? And also they are called as unicellular. Uni means small, one, and cellular. Cellular structure, one cell is there only. So these organisms are called as, those who are having only one cell, they are called as unicellular organisms or microscopic organisms. But very important thing is that whatever the activities performed by all the higher or the multicellular organisms, all that same activities are performed by the unicellular organisms also. For example, we can say that amoeba or paramecia. So this amoeba and paramecia is a unicellular organism, but along with that one cell, they perform the digestion, they perform the respiration, they perform the excretion, and they perform the reproduction process also. Okay, only the difference in the multicellular and the unicellular is that to perform the processes, all these different processes in the multicellular, different organ system is there. But in the unicellular, only one cell perform all these different functions. Okay, so this is all about what? Unicellular organism. Now let's say about the multicellular. Multi means what? Many. So the organisms which are having the many more cells, or the organism made up of the many cells, then that organisms are called as what? Multicellular organism. So as we know, our body performs so many different activities, so many different functions. Okay, and very important is that in the multicellular, to perform that different functions, we are having different organs or organ system. For example, if we talk about the digestion, then we are having the digestive system, we are having the digestive organ. Along with the digestive organ, the digestive system performs their work. Then circulation system is there for circulation, different organs are there. Respiration system is there for respiration, different organs are there. So like that, there is a distribution of labor. Okay, means this work will be done by this organ. Digestive organs will do digestion, circulatory organs will do circulation. Like that, distribution of the labor is there, division of labor is there in the multicellular. But in the unicellular, only one cell performs the all different work. Okay, so this is what unicellular and multicellular. If we talk about the examples of the multicellular, then we can say human being, different plants and animals that we can see around us that are visible to us, that all the organisms are multicellular organisms. Okay, so this is all about today. Up till now we have discussed about the discovery and history of the cell. Also we have discussed the instruments for studying cell, and also we have discussed staining and very important unicellular and the multicellular organisms. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We'll meet in the next video with the next point, and for today, thank you.